Hello and welcome to Bohemian Cello Expansion 1 tutorial on legatos. Bowed instruments have two basic categories of legatos, bow-changed and on-bow. The term legato is used here for what happens during the note change from one pitch to another during a connected phrase. In our Soul Capture series, we have sampled all our legatos chromatically, moving up and down by semitone. And in terms of intervals, we've also captured them by semitones. Therefore, you end up with 12 intervals going up, 12 intervals going down. That's in multiple speeds and multiple motions and multiple dynamics. So it's quite a lot of legatos, and we haven't cheated anything there. We actually captured all of these with our musicians. So bow changed, meaning a new bow stroke on each note during the pitch change, is one of the legatos, and to activate it, you simply do not overlap your notes, and it will look something like this. The correct bow types are selected by the performer, and the legato interval will be played if the time between the notes is short. Of course, if you leave a larger gap, and the bow has completely ended and lifted off the string for a while, like in the real world, then it will use a completely new bow opening with no prior bow changed interval, like in the real world if you left a gap between the bow strokes. A better way for a phrase like we just had would be to use a combination of bow changed and on bow legato. Now, on bow legato will be used on all the overlapped notes. So to generally activate on bow legato, all you need to do is overlap the notes, and the performer will choose whichever one is the best. And we will see that what happens now when it's on the same bow, you can get more fluent and realistic flow of the phrase like this. Of course, depending on the emotion you wish to convey. Our on-bow legato consists of further variations, such as fingered, slurred. These are determined by the legato type you use. Whole note and half note legatos will have combinations of fingered and slurred based on what you would, or what the cellist rather, would naturally use, given the interval, originator note, etc. And the quarter note and trills and runs will use fingered legato, as it is more suitable for the fast passages. This might mean also changing of the string, of course. Let us take a listen to the difference in musical approach by full legato, then quarter note legato. I will be forcing this on, so the performer doesn't engage the legato type it believes would fit the best for this phrase. And a last playthrough will be with no force keys, so the performer chooses the legato for us. Each legato type is suitable for different phrases, and our virtual performer takes care of this selection on your behalf, but of course you can force specific legato types yourself if and when needed. Another performance technique with our instruments is trilling. Basically, you hold the root note down, from which you wish to trill, and then tap quickly the trill notes. The performer will spot that you are trilling and use the appropriate legato for said action once you've reached the appropriate momentum. Lastly, you can force portamento on any of the transitions, and it will give you a pronounced portamento on the legato. We have again captured these in 12 intervals, plural dynamics, per each semitone up and down. You can even do little tricks with it like this, which give you something like a glissando or a run on a single finger. But please remember, portamento is like a rare spice. It is great to season your meal with, but if you use too much of it, you might ruin your dinner. So we always say, well, at least us string players do, to use it sparingly and carefully. I hope you found this quick tutorial helpful, and I hope to see you on our other videos.